Steve Patterson here from Photoshop Essentials. Today we'll look at a new AI feature in Photoshop 2025 called Select People, and how you can use it to select a person, or multiple people, or even specific regions of a person, all using AI. Now, Select People is in the official Photoshop release, so you don't need the Photoshop beta. I'm going to start with this photo of just a single person, so we can cover the basics. But later, I'll show you how to use it with photos of two or more people as well. I'll also show you a few ways to clean up any problems with your selections, how to convert the selection into a layer mask, and even how you might replace a problem area using Generative Fill. So Select People is a new feature that's been added to the Object Selection tool. So first, we need to choose the Object Selection tool from the toolbar. Then, before you go any further, go up to the Options bar, click on the arrow next to Select Subject, and make sure that Cloud is selected. And this will give you better and more detailed results by processing the image on the cloud using Adobe's servers rather than on your computer. In fact, there's really no reason not to use the cloud as long as your computer is connected to the internet. So if you want Photoshop to choose the cloud by default, just open Photoshop's Preferences. On a Windows PC, go up to the Edit menu and choose Preferences. On a Mac, you'll want to go to the Photoshop menu and choose Settings. From here, choose Image Processing. Then change Select Subject and Remove Background from Device to Cloud. And that's all there is to it. Photoshop will choose the cloud automatically from now on. So back in the Options bar, click the new Select People button. And Photoshop displays a thumbnail for each person in your image that it detected. I only have one person in this photo, so it detected just that one person. If you hover your cursor over the thumbnail, that person is highlighted with a color overlay. By default, the overlay is magenta, but I'll show you how to change it in a moment. Now, the person is not selected yet, they're just highlighted. If you click on the thumbnail, you'll see different options. At the top is a button to select the entire person, but you'll also see buttons for each individual region of the person that Photoshop detected. Now, there are more than 20 regions or attributes that Photoshop can detect, but it will only show the ones that it found for this person in this image. When you hover over a button, that region of the person is highlighted. So I can highlight her teeth, her mouth, her nose, and so on. Again, none of these regions are selected yet. We're just seeing the areas that Photoshop detected. To choose a region, just click its button. I'll choose facial skin. Notice that it did not select her nose, but that's okay because we can choose more than one region at a time. I'll click on ears as well to choose all three regions. Then to actually create the selection, click the Apply button. And the selection outline appears. I'm going to remove the selection by going to Select and then Deselect, so I can show you a faster way to work. But before we continue, if you're having trouble seeing that magenta overlay, click the gear icon. Then down in the Overlay options, you can choose a different color. You can also increase the opacity of the overlay. I'll increase it to 50%. And then I'll press Enter or Return on a Mac to accept it. So we've seen that we can click the Select People button to choose the person or regions we want to select. But you actually don't need to use it because there's a faster way to work. With the Object Selection tool active, just move your mouse cursor over a person to highlight the different regions that Photoshop detected. If you hover just outside the edge of a person, you'll highlight the entire person. But I want to highlight her outfit, so I'll hover over it. And by the way, if you're not seeing the regions highlighting, click the gear icon and make sure that Find People Details on Canvas is checked. I'll hover over her outfit again to highlight it. And then, to select the region, just click on it. And again, the selection outline appears. But even though Select People uses AI, the selections won't always be perfect. If I zoom in on the back of her outfit, notice that Photoshop included some of the background, so I need to clean that up. Now, in a moment, I'll show you how to convert the selection into a layer mask. And I could wait until I've converted it to a mask and then clean up this area on the mask. Or I can clean up the selection before converting it to a mask. It really makes no difference because a selection and a layer mask are the same thing. In this case, I'm going to clean up the selection first. And one of the easiest ways to do that is with the selection brush tool. So I'll grab it from the toolbar. The selection brush is great because it lets you simply paint over the areas you want to select. And it displays the selection with the same magenta overlay, so it's easier to see. In this case, I want to use it not to add to the selection, but to remove an area. So in the options bar, I'll change the mode from add to subtract. I'll reduce the size of my brush using the left bracket key on my keyboard, and then I'll just paint along that edge to remove the background. If I make a mistake and paint away too much, I can switch the mode back to add, and then just paint to add the area back in. I'll zoom my image back out by going up to the View menu and choosing Fit on Screen. And then to bring back the selection outline, I'll switch back to the Object Selection tool. So now that her outfit is selected, I can easily change its color. I'll go to the Adjustments panel. I'll make sure that Single Adjustments is selected, and I'll choose Hue Saturation. In the Layers panel, we see the Hue Saturation adjustment layer above the image. And because the selection was active when I added the adjustment layer, Photoshop automatically converted the selection to a layer mask. The white area of the mask is her outfit, and the black area is everything else that was not selected, which means that any changes I make with the adjustment layer will affect only her outfit. So I'll go to the Properties panel, and I'll simply drag the hue slider to the left to change her outfit's color. And that's the basics of how to select and edit an area using Select People. So let's switch over to a second image, this time with more than one person. Again, I'll choose the Object Selection tool, and then I'll click Select People. Photoshop detected all five people in the image, but it's only showing three thumbnails. So I'll click the +2 button, and now we see all five. If you hover your cursor over a thumbnail, you'll see just that one person highlighted. Or if you hover over the gray icon in the upper left, all of the people Photoshop detected will be highlighted. And this is useful if Photoshop missed someone because you can easily see which person was missed. But in this case, everyone was detected. If you click on a person's thumbnail, you'll see the same buttons we saw earlier where you can select the entire person or specific regions. But you can also choose two or more people at a time by clicking their thumbnail. Then if I choose a shared attribute like hair, the hair on all three of them is highlighted. And this makes it easy to choose the same region for multiple people in your photo. I'm going to choose everyone at once by clicking the gray icon in the upper left. Then I want to select all of the t-shirts. So I'll click on Upper Close. And then I'll click Apply to create the selection. Overall, the selection looks great. There are a few spots that were missed, but I'll come back to those in a moment. I want to change the color of the t-shirts. So I'll go to the Adjustments panel, and with Single Adjustments selected, I'll choose Hue Saturation. Again, we see the adjustment layer that was added above the image. And Photoshop converted the selection into a layer mask. The white areas are the t-shirts. So now I can change the color of all five t-shirts at once. I'll go to the Properties panel, and I want all 5 shirts to be the same color, so I'll click the Colorize option. Then I'll drag the Hue slider to the right to choose a blue color that matches their jeans. And this looks pretty good so far. But if I zoom in on the person second from the right, and I'll switch to a different tool to hide that overlay, we see that Photoshop missed a few spots, especially near her upper left shoulder. There's another spot over on the right. And because there's so much hair in these areas, fixing this could be a challenge. There's another spot here I'll need to clean up as well. So I'm going to break this problem down into 2 steps. First, I'll add those missing areas of the t-shirt to the mask, and then I'll worry about the hair. So with the layer mask selected in the Layers panel, I'll choose the Brush tool from the toolbar. I'll make sure my foreground color, the brush color, is set to white so I can add those areas to the mask. I'll increase the size of my brush using the right bracket key on my keyboard, and then I'll just start painting over those areas to add them to the mask. And notice that I'm also making the hair blue in the areas where I'm painting, but I'll worry about that later. I'll zoom in a bit closer, and then I'll paint along the edge. And I'll grab those other areas that I missed. I'll move down to the sleeves so I can add this area that was missed. Then I'll move up to the right shoulder and add this area. Again, notice that I'm turning the hair blue, but I'll fix that in the next step. Then there's just one more spot down here with these sleeves. If I paint over too much of an area, I can just press the X key on my keyboard to switch my foreground color from white to black, and then paint over those same areas again to hide them. Sometimes it's easier to sort of paint outside the lines and then go back and clean things up. And it looks like there's a few remaining problems along these edges, so I'll paint over those to add them. And I think that's it. So if I zoom back out and we take another look at those areas, it looks like I missed that spot right there. And now the t-shirt is looking good. But her hair in those areas is also blue. To fix it, I need to remove the hair from the mask. Thankfully, hair is one of the regions we can now select with the Object Selection tool. So I'll switch to the Object Selection tool. And actually, I'll switch to the Move tool first, just to hide the overlay while I zoom out. And now I'll choose the Object Selection tool. But notice when I try to select her hair by hovering over it, that Photoshop is selecting the entire image. And that's because I have the wrong layer selected in the Layers panel. But I can fix that in the Options bar by clicking Sample All Layers. And now I can hover over her hair to highlight it and click on it to select it. To remove the hair from the mask, I need to fill the selection with black. So I'll go up to the Edit menu and choose Fill. Then I'll set the contents to black and click OK. I'll clear the selection by going to the Select menu and choosing Deselect. Then I'll switch to the Move tool just to hide the overlay. And when I zoom in, we see that most of the hair is back to its original color. But there are still a few areas where we can see the original t-shirt color through the hair. So one thing I could do here is simply replace those areas with new AI-generated content. And I can do that using Generative Fill. First, I need to select those areas, so I'll grab the selection brush from the toolbar. I'll paint over the areas I want to replace to select them. Now I have my contextual taskbar hidden at the moment, so I'll bring it back by going up to the Window menu and choosing Contextual Taskbar. I'll click the Generative Fill button, and I don't need to add a prompt, so I'll just click Generate. And after a few seconds, Photoshop replaces those areas with new AI content. If I toggle the new Generative Fill layer on and off, we can compare the original problem areas with the new content. Let's see what the second result looks like. I think this one looks much better. I'll try the third one, but I like the second one the best. Again, here's without the new AI content, and here's with it. I'll zoom the image back out by going to the View menu and choosing Fit on Screen. And there we have it. That's at least a few ways to use the new Select People feature in Photoshop. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more Photoshop tutorials. You can also join my Patreon for exclusive content, and you'll find a link in the description. Thanks so much for watching. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.